So what are your odds of being struck by lightning? Now, to tell you all these things are coincidences, I went over 15 different signs from the Bible. You guys can go through and count them later. I actually gave you more than 15, but I'm only going to count 15 for a reason. So your odds of being struck by lightning. So right here, we'll read this little short thing right here. It says, according to the National Weather Service, that's the NWS, a person has a 1 in 15,300 chance of getting struck by lightning in their lifetime. A 1 in 15,300 chance of being struck by lightning in your lifetime. So, to add perspective to this for people who aren't good with ratios, that means that if you had, let's just break it down to terms of a lottery ticket. If there were, let's say each person had one lottery ticket, there were 15,300 lottery tickets. Your odds of getting struck by lightning is the same as the odds of them pulling the lottery ticket and you being the one winner out of those 15,300. Most people would not get their hopes up if there were 15,300 entries, everybody had one. People would want to win, but most people aren't going to be surprised if they don't win. And this is important for context. Your odds of being eaten by a shark. The odds of being attacked and killed by a shark are 1 in 3,748,067. So now, this is where, again, we need context. If there are 3,748,067 lottery tickets, the odds of you being eaten by a shark is the same odds as somebody pulling one ticket and you being the winner out of 3,748,067 people with just one ticket. Your odds of getting killed by a vending machine is 1 in 112 million. 112 million people with lottery tickets. The odds of you winning that lottery, you would have to be, very lucky out of 112 million people to be the one that got pulled, or it would have to be by design. It either has to be luck or it has to be designed for you to be the person to catch that winning lottery ticket out of 112 million people with lottery tickets. So what is the odds of winning the Powerball jackpot? The odds of winning the Powerball jackpot are 1 in 292 million. So if 292 million people had lottery tickets, the odds of you winning Powerball is the odds of your ticket being pulled out of those 292 million people. You either have to be extremely lucky or it has to be by design for you to hit that winning lottery ticket. And yet people will tell us that certain things are coincidences. Do me a favor, share this video, hit the thumbs up if you haven't done so already. Do me a favor, press one if you've ever won a lottery. Press one. If anybody in here has ever hit the Powerball jackpot or the lottery, please do me a favor and press one. Your odds are 1 in 292 million. Now, keep in mind, there's only roughly 7 billion people on the planet Earth. So now, did I pull this up? Nah, we don't need that. What are the odds of getting struck by lightning 7 times? So I looked this up. You guys can see. What are the odds of getting struck by lightning 7 times? So now, your odds of getting struck by lightning 7 times is 1 in 10 to the 28th power. That is 10 with 28 zeros behind it. I'm not even sure what this number would be. It's 1 with 28 zeros behind. That's your chance of getting struck by lightning 7 times. Now, I tell you this because, like I said in the beginning, men lie, women lie, the numbers don't. What are the odds? So now, I ask myself that question. What are the odds? What are the odds that there would be all these signs in the Bible? Let me get the chart real quick. Let me pull this chart down here because I want to make sure I have everything where it needs to be. So what are the odds that we would fit, you know, certain prophecies on this chart? There are 61 total prophecies that I've pulled out of the Bible so far on this chart. And again, you guys can get this chart at the link in the comments section. 61. So yeah, they're all numbered 61. What are the odds that these prophecies would fit us? Because we've been told we take scripture out of context. We've been told we're reading it wrong. People say that these people are having false visions, and yet all these visions led to the truth. It led to history that supports the claim. It led to DNA that supports the claim. The geography supports the claim. Language we have found supports the claim. Archaeology has supported the claim. But does the math support the claim? And to my knowledge, nobody has touched on the mathematical probability that we are Israel. Men lie, women lie, the numbers don't. So again, keep this in mind. The odds of getting struck by lightning 7 times is 1 in 10 to the 28th power. That means if there are this many people, there's not even this many people on earth, but if there was this many people with a lottery ticket right here, if there were this many people with a lottery ticket, this would mean your odds of being picked, you would either have to be extremely lucky, or it would have to be by design. The game would have to be rigged for you to win. It's either extremely lucky or the game has to be rigged. Keep that in mind. And the reason I'm showing you this is because we're going to come back to this number in a second. So what I did, I sent this over to some professors at Harvard. I'm going to go over these numbers in a second. I sent these numbers over to some professors at Harvard. Give me a second here. Now, the reason I'm moving this is because I'm going to go over these numbers in a second. But I sent it like this. There's nothing on there. All right. There is nothing on here as far as an explanation of anything. Now, I'm showing you guys this for a reason. There's just a bunch of numbers. You guys don't know what these numbers mean unless you know what they mean. So now I'm going to give you. Let me see here. I'm going to give you an explanation of these numbers in a second. But I just want you guys to look. I just sent. This is what I sent over to Harvard. Now, right here, these are the professors I emailed. All of these professors. Only one of them got back to me. And I'm going to read you his email back to me. He actually did ask me not to reveal his information, which is interesting. But if you guys want to, you guys can email all. Here's their contact information. Is Harvard Department of Mathematics, Harvard University. This right here has all their contact information for all of these people at Harvard University in the mathematics department. And you guys can contact them. Maybe they'll answer you. Maybe they won't. But here's why it's not important which professor answered. Because this is a basic math equation. Anybody can verify this. In fact, not only am I going to give you the link to the professors at Harvard, but I'm going to give you the link to all the professors at MIT. And you can run these numbers by them as well and do your own independent verifications. If you know how to calculate odds and probabilities, you can do that. If you have a probabilities calculator, if you know how to do it manually, feel free to check the math. The math is the math. It doesn't matter which professor did or didn't respond. The math is the math. So I sent them over the math. Here is the email I sent. I'll read it right here. I BCC. You can see I BCC'd all of these professors. These are all the professors on the Harvard thing. It says, my name is Dante Fortson. I'm working on a YouTube video which will feature a probability calculation. I just wanted to make sure my math is correct before posting the video. Attaches a PDF showing my calculation results. Alternatively, here is a brief summary of my results if you don't feel comfortable opening the attachment. The calculation is the probability of 15 out of 61 specific events happening to one specific group of people, similar to choosing numbers on a Keno card. Here are my results. 5 events, 1 chance in 5,949,147. 10 events is going to be, let me just show you. 10 events is going to be 1 chance, and that is 90 billion, 177,170,138. Or, as you can see, 3.2723415 times 10 to the 17th power. Now, I did these calculations myself. This is the calculation I got. 15 prophecies would be 1,070,539,987,826,694, or 9.22433340 times 10 to the 25th power. That would be the probability of Israel fitting these prophecies. So I just sent over the numbers because you only need the numbers. You don't need the context that we're talking about Israel or anything else, because men lie, women lie, the numbers don't. So I emailed all these guys and only one got back to me. This is what he said. You have a calculation error, in parentheses, rounding error. The denominators you want are, now let me stop right there, because when he said I had an error, I'm like, whoa, I might be way off. The denominators you want are 5,949,147. So my original, this is what I got, 5,949,147. So I got the probability. So the probability of Israel, of black people here in America fitting just five of these events is 1 in 5,949,147. So let's see. 1 in 5 million. So you have a greater chance of being attacked and killed by the shark than just five of those prophecies fitting black people in America. Now, that math was spot on right there, my first calculation. So in the second calculation, he says the first one is correct, but the others need more precise arithmetic than you have done. Also, please do not mention my name in your video. I already get too many messages like yours and do not wish to attract any attention and receive any more than I already do. This is right here, sincerely, his name. And it says Harvard University Department of Mathematics has the address. And this is math.harvard.edu. Now, again, it doesn't matter which professor responded, because you can independently check the math. And again, the list of all the Harvard professors, the link will be posted, and the link to all the MIT mathematics department will be posted as well. You can check these numbers independently yourself. So now, he gives me this one for the 10. So 10 out of 61 of these would be 90,177,220,126. Matter of fact, let me just show you this right here. So my first one was correct right here. The end times prophecy probability chart, this version 1.0. This will be available for download after the after this is over. You guys can go download it yourself. And so let me explain this before I go too far into the second one. So the odds of one or so five prophecies being fulfilled out of the 61, here's how you calculate probability. For those of you who don't know how to calculate probability, you take the total number of possibilities. So we have 61 possibilities according to this chart. 61 possibilities. You then put 5 over 61. That's so out of these events, you're out of, so if five events are to fit, you're going to choose five events. Now, your odds of getting just one of those to come up is 5 in 61. So now that one is done, you take the remaining left. So your odds of getting two would be 4 in 60. Your odds of getting three would be 3 in 59, four would be 2 in 58, and the odds of getting all five would be 1 chance in 57. Now, what you do is you multiply the numerator. To get the numerator, you're going to multiply 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which will give you 120. To get the denominator, you're going to multiply 61 times 60 times 59 times 58 times 57 and so on, which gives you the number 713 million 897,640 as the denominator. And then in order to get the ratio, you're going to divide the denominator by the numerator. So it's going to be 713,897,640 divided by 120, which will give you a ratio of one chance in 5,949,147. So if that many people had a lottery ticket, that would be your chances in winning. So it would either have to be lucky or by design. It's not impossible to win a lottery with less than 6 million entries. You wouldn't be surprised if you didn't win, but it would not be impossible for you to win if all things were equal and everybody only had one single ticket. So now let's go back to the email. He corrects my math. 90,177,170. 226. So now let's see what my math was. I went ahead and I put the correct. So here's all 10. I've already explained how this works. So now, because there's 10, you would start at 10 and you would go backwards. You would multiply all the numerators. You would multiply all the denominators and you would get the result of 3,628,800 as the numerator and 3.272,3415 times 10 to the 17th power as the denominator. Now, this right here was my original that I sent over to him. I put them side by side so you can see it. 1 in 90,177,170. Thousand, or let's see, 100, let me say it again, 90,177,170,138.889 chances of this being, you know, a coincidence. It would have to be a extremely lucky or it'd have to be rigged. And here's where he corrected me. Now notice his numbers are the same up to this point. We're dealing in the billions now. He rounded up. He said it needs to be, what do you say? It needs more precise arithmetic than you have done. So his rounding up actually came to a slightly higher number. Mine was 138. He got 226. But other than that, the rest of it is the same. But that slightly raises the odds. But basically, your chance, the chance of Israel or black people in America fitting 10 of these 61 prophecies. Remember, I gave you over 15. If you go back and count them, I gave you over 15. If you grab the chart has them marked which ones we fit. So when the probability of us fitting 10 of the 61 prophecies is the same thing as having a lottery ticket and 90,177,170,226 other people on the whole planet had a lottery ticket. The odds are the same as winning that drawing that we would fit just 10 of the prophecies. That means we have to be super extremely lucky or the game has to be rigged in that direction so that we win. There's not even 90 billion people on Earth. There's roughly 7 billion. Even if we said 9 billion people, even if we said there were 9 billion people on Earth, you'd be 10 times more likely to win a lottery with 9 billion people on Earth and you have the winning ticket than you are for Israel, for black people to fit the prophecies, 10 of these prophecies by coincidence. It's just more likely. This is not a coincidence. But I went even further and got to 15. It says right here. He corrects me again. This number is 70,539,987,820, or expressed in a mathematical equation. You see it here. Again, you could download this. This would result in 1,307,674,368,000 as the numerator, and the denominator would be 9.224,3340 times 10 to the 25th power. So the reason I brought up the odds of winning this, so if we take off three zeros and we only imagine this number right here, This is 10 to the 25th power right here. Don't count the highlighted zeros. That would be 10 to the 28th. Like, so you are only slightly more likely. It's only slightly more likely that we fit the prophecies than it is to get struck by lightning 7 times. Only slightly more likely to fit 15 prophecies than it is to get struck by lightning 7 times. If you get struck by lightning 7 times, it's likely not an accident. It's likely you're either doing something you aren't supposed to be doing. I'm talking about those people that chase lightning and be up there playing with the poles and you know, setting up that sort of stuff. Or something has it out for you. Someone has it out for you. And I don't believe somebody's going to get coincidentally struck by lightning 7 times. So let me get back to, so he corrected me in the email right here. My original calculation, 70,539,987,826,694. He corrected me, 842,520. So his number is slightly higher than mine, which means the probability of this being coincidence goes up. Well, not being coincidence goes up. So again, the lottery ticket, the chances of us fitting 15 out of 61 prophecies is the equivalent of Israel holding one lottery ticket out of 70 trillion lottery tickets. 70,539,987,842,520 lottery tickets. The odds of us fitting 15 out of 61 prophecies is the same odds as us having one lottery ticket and winning that lottery among 70.5 trillion other people. We don't have a trillion people on the planet. So now let me show you guys a visual representation of just how big a trillion is. Now, here is the whole prophecy chart. This is the one you guys will be able to download. It won't be split up like this. I did this for the video. Yeah, let me move this up here. I did this for the video so you guys wouldn't see the results before I got to them. But this is what the actual prophecy chart will look like that you download. I have my original calculation on here, and I do have the corrected one from the Harvard professor. And again, you guys can independently verify these numbers. Men lie, women lie, the numbers don't. The numbers are the numbers, regardless if you apply them to whoever you want to. So now the prophecy fulfillment calculation, I added that on here. So 15 out of 61 prophecies means that we fulfill 24.59016393444263% of the prophecies. And yeah, the number only grows because what I didn't calculate was how many prophecies we actually fulfill. I will be filling out this chart more, but as I have calculated right now, or I'll say based on what I know, we fulfill at least 19 of those 61 prophecies. I only did calculations for 15, and the more prophecies you add, the more this number will go up right here. 9.22433340 times 10 to the 25th power. It will exceed the probability of your chances of being struck by lightning 7 times. And it's either a coincidence or it's by design. Either we're winning the lottery by extreme luck, or the game is rigged, and the person controlling the game, and I'll use that word person loosely, the one controlling the game rigged it so that we are the people, and the one controlling the game knew the outcome. So let me show you. Watch this video. How big is a trillion? Let me go ahead and mute my mic so you guys can hear the video.
How big is 1 trillion? You know, for humans, it's really hard for us to get our heads around these really large numbers. Like really, what's the difference between a million, a billion, and a trillion? Well, one of the ways to really think about it is to break it down to something, a scale we can really understand. So if you think about a million as 1 foot, about this long, a billion is 1,000 millions, or about 1,000 feet. That would be like a, say, 3 or maybe 4 minute walk for you to do. Like, still very doable. But what about a trillion? How big is a trillion? Well, a trillion is 1,000 billions. So don't worry, I'm not gonna make you do any math or dig out a calculator. But if a million is 1 foot, a trillion is almost 200 miles. It's technically 189 miles. So think about that. The next time you hear people throwing around these numbers like millions and billions, there's a huge difference between a trillion and a million.
All right, so you heard him. There's a huge difference between a trillion and a million, but we're dealing with 70 trillion. He said a trillion is roughly 200 miles. So if we multiply that by 70, we end up with about 14,000 miles. 14,000 miles. That's the distance to a to 70 trillion. So again, men lie, women lie. The numbers don't. We have proven ourselves through the Bible. People can say we're interpreting it wrong and we're taking it out of context, but it led us to the history, which proved our point. It led us to the DNA, which proved our point. It led us to the geography, the language, the archaeology, and now the math is on our side. The odds that we fit just 15 out of these 61 are 1 in 70 trillion, 539,000, a billion. 987,842,520. Do me a favor. If you knew that there were, if you knew you could only buy one lottery ticket and 70 trillion other people were going to buy a lottery ticket and your chance was 1 in 70 trillion, would you go out and buy that lottery ticket? How many of you would go out and bet everything you have on that lottery ticket to win? Do me a favor, press 1 if you would bet everything you have on a 1 in 70 trillion chance to win the lottery. And do me a favor if you say, you know what, those odds are absurd and my chances of winning, being right, are almost zero. Not completely impossible, because you got one chance in 70 trillion. It's not completely impossible, but the odds are so far stacked against you to make it highly improbable that you would win. And yet here we are. In America, black people in America, some going off visions, some going off history, some going off DNA, some going off strictly the Bible, and we all reach the same conclusion that we are the people. And then we look at the history, the language, the DNA, the geography, the archaeology, and now the math, and we see that we were right. What are the odds? Do we believe our Bible, or do we believe the doctrine?